Hi everybody, I'm Ed from Chicago Fly House, and today we want to talk about why it is that we use internal batten couplers instead of external threaded pipe couplers when we're putting our battens together. So most of us have seen the pipe couplers that we use, where we use an internal piece of pipe, we put it between our battens like this, and we have bolt holes that we line up and we can bolt that way. This one's a boltable version. There are others where you use set screws to press two plates together and do a press fit version. Generally speaking, we say that that's the right way to do it. We don't necessarily talk about why, and so we want to look at that today. The other option would be to take a pipe coupler like this, a threaded coupler. This one's for rigid conduit, which is basically the same size as pipe. This one is for actual fluid transmitting pipe, but they're essentially the same idea. We thread the pipes together, we tighten them with a wrench, and then we trust that connection. And so why is one better than the other? We thought we'd take a look at that today. So before we show you the footage, we want to talk about what we did to test these. You figure that for a batten, an average length between pickup lines could be 8 feet, 10 feet, even up to like 13 feet. And a connection that's not supported at a lift line could see a lot of force and see a lot of flex with that much pipe to bend. We didn't have that much room to do that in our testing lab here. What we've done is we used basically a 24-inch length of pipe with a connector in the middle. And so we're pulling on that to see what's happening. Now, that's probably a stronger connection. We're going to see a little less flex than we would across a full batten, but it still tells the story pretty well. The other thing is that in our current situation, we are able to put about 3,000 pounds of force on these pipes. And so basically we attempted to max out the connection and see what would happen, but it's entirely possible we could break the connection with more force. Having said all that, let's take a look at the tape. Okay, so looking at those tests, it's a pretty clear reasoning behind why we don't do this, right? The internal batten coupler was able to take the full 3,000 pounds of load, whereas the threaded coupler blew apart, and we see the threads have very definitively ripped out of it. We can see on both the pipe and on the coupler itself, the threads just tore away under much less force than the full 3,000 pounds. The other thing we want to pay attention to is that when we bent the splice, this is the splice that we bent it all the way down. It had a big sag in it. And now when we bring it back, it's actually almost straight again. It's really quite close to being the same as it was before we pulled on it, which means that even though we loaded it with force, it bounced back and retained its strength. It stayed in the elastic zone of material behavior, which means it's basically retaining its strength. So that's a pretty clear indication that we should be choosing the internal couplers as opposed to threaded pipe couplers. And of course, that's to say nothing of the fact that threaded pipe couplers can vibrate themselves loose, and you'd have to be making sure you were tightening them pretty often as well. That's it for today. Let us know if you have comments, questions, anything like that, drop it in the comments. If you have ideas for more videos you want to see, stuff you want to see us test, let us know that too. Thanks a lot.